Hello everyone, in this video we will be seeing about introduction to Indian constitution. So this subject 18 CPC 39, it's a one credit subject. Okay, so first module, it is about the introduction to Indian constitution, how they have proposed the constitution, how it came into existence. So all these things you will be seeing in this module. So the first one is introduction to Indian constitution. So the first one we should know is, why do we need this constitution? The constitution, it was passed by the Constituent Assembly on 26th November 1949 and is fully applicable since 26th January 1950. Thanks to the help of Professor K.B. Agarwal, the ICL edition of the constitution now incorporates all amendments until and including the 78th amendment in 1995, 30th August 1995. There are no newer amendments until 1996 December. Amendments after December 1996 have not yet been included. So India, it is a federal democratic republic of 25 states and 7 union territories. Each state is administered by governor appointed by the president, while each union territory is administered by the president through a minister. The bicameral parliament is composed of the Council of States Rajya Sabha and House of the People Lok Sabha. The Council of States will consist of 250 members, out of which the president will nominate 12 persons having special knowledge or practical experience in respect of literature, art, science and social service. The remaining 238 seats are to be filled in by the persons to be elected by the legislative assemblies of their respective states in staggered re-elections of 1/3 every second year. The House of People is composed of 550 members, in which 530 members are from the states and 20 members are from the union territories. So there are some extraordinary features the Indian of an Indian system of government. For example, the constitution, it encourages the states to have unicameral legislatures. Upper houses are re-elected to 1/3 of their members every 2 years. Legislative members are chosen by direct election. The states of Andhra Pradesh, Manipur and Haryana have already banned the production and the possession and consumption of alcohol. So this is about the necessity of the constitution. So the next one is making of the constitution. So the making of constitution, the Constituent Assembly, which had been elected for undivided India and held its first sitting on 9th December 1946, reassembled on 14th August 1947 as the sovereign Constituent Assembly for the dominion of India. In regard to its composition, the members were elected by the indirect election by the members of the provisional legislative assemblies, lower house only. According to the schemes recommended by the cabinet to the essentials, the schemes were as follows. So each province and each Indian state or group of states were allotted the total number of seats proportional to their respective population, roughly in the ratio of 1:10,00,000. As a result, the province were to elect 292 members, while Indian states were allotted out the minimum of 93 states. The seats in each province were distributed among the three main communities, Muslim, Sikh and general, in proportion to their respective populations. So members of each community in the provisional legislative assembly elected their own representatives by the method of proportional representation with single transferable vote. The method of selection in case of representatives of Indian states was determined by consultation. So the next one is about the milestones in the development of the constitution. So if we take about the milestones in the constitution, the Regulating Act 1773, the Charter Act 1793, the Charter Act 1813, the Charter Act 1833, the Charter Act 1853. Next is about British Paramountcy End of Company Rule. So British Paramountcy End of Company Rule, the first war of independence in the 1857, the Government of India Act 1858, the Indian Councils Act 1861, Formation of Indian National Congress in 1885, the Indian Council Act 1892, the split of Congress and demand for Swaraj. So this is the second milestone. And the third one is Congress in extremist phase. Congress in extremist phase, the Government of Act India 1909, the Government of India Act 1919, the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy 1919, advent of Gandhiji. Advent of Gandhiji Non-Cooperation Movement 1920, Simon Commission 1927, Nehru Report 1928, and Civil Disobedience 1930. So the next milestone is Government of India Act 1935, backbone of our present constitution. So Government of India Act 1935, backbone of our present constitution, federation and provisional autonomy, Diachi at the center, a bicameral central legislature created, distribution of powers between center and provinces, demand for constituent assembly. So a demand for constituent assembly, the act 1935 failed to entertain the Indian aspirations. In 1938, Pandit Nehru formulated the demand for constituent assembly. So the next is about the next milestone is CRISP mission, acceptance of demand, which came in 1942 and recognized the demand that a constitution to be framed by an elected constituent assembly, India to be given a dominion status. CRISP proposal were rejected. Gandhiji started Quit India movement in 1942. Next is cabinet mission, formation of constituent assembly. The cabinet mission provided for an ideal indirectly elected constituent assembly. The assembly consists of totally 389 members, 292 to be elected from provinces, 93 to be nominated from princely states, and 4 to be nominated from chief commercial areas. Next is Joint Constitution of Assembly for India and Pakistan. Joint Constitution Assembly for India and Pakistan, the first meeting was held on December 9, 1946, but it was boycotted by Muslim League. Next is the Mountbatten Plan, Indian Act 1947. Mountbatten Plan, India 1947. On 26th July 1947, Governor General Lord Mountbatten announced the setting up of separate Constituent Assembly for Pakistan. Constituent Assembly for India was formulated on 14th August 1947, the Sovereign Constituent Assembly for India reassembled. Dr. Rajendra Prasad was the first president. 7-member drafting committee formed by Dr. Ambedkar as he acted as a chairman for drafting committee. Drafting constitution. So it took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days in framing the constitution. The constitution was enacted and adopted on 26th November 1949. Some of the provisions relating to citizenship, election, provisional parliament, etc. came into force on the same day. Remaining provisions came into force on 26th January 1950. So the Constitution of India has some unique and distinct features as compared to other constitutions of the world. As Dr. Ambedkar, the chairman of the drafting committee, framers had tried to accumulate and accommodate the best features for of other constitutions, keeping in view the peculiar problems and needs of our country. So this is about the need of the constitution. Why do we need this constitution? What are the things helped in bringing getting up the freedom and bringing the constitution to be a favorable one for our society. Since we are having many issues, it has made us a lengthy constitution by checking all the other